indeed a matter of great pleasure that we are trying and making attempts to give due place to safety, health and environment at workplace. We have come a long way since our Tryst of Destiny days, and India is proud to be one of the industrial powers. Mr. Mathur well rightly said, on the one hand we say we are a developed industrial nation, but when it comes to standards, we take shelters both in WTO discussions, in other discussions, saying that we are a developing nation, different standards should apply. Time has come that we address these concerns, and the first thing which I hope when you all deliberate, a major mindset is that any expenditure on safety, health or environment is an expenditure. Let's get out of this mindset. It's not an expenditure at all. It's an investment that is capitalized over the years, both in terms of improved productivity. We somehow ignore that workers' commitment is a function of productivity, and his commitment is very inextricably linked with the kind of environment he works, the kind of standards, safety standards he is subjected to. So this is a very serious matter which needs to be seriously addressed. The department is there, the Government of India regulations are there. Let's not take them as regulations. It's a very wrong word to call the department as a regulator. It's on the part of the department, at least I would like to comment, that we are here to aid, advise, assist and facilitate. Regulations are there, and as somebody, Ms. Mathur was saying, we have to go beyond them, we have to strive for excellence. I'm sure this gathering will come out with issues. I'm only reminded of an incident which happened in Goa about the naphtha leak. You know, somewhere somebody did not take adequate precaution, and what happened we all know. You know, minor issues unattended give rise to major accidents. Minor issues unattended give rise to unintended consequences in terms of health and safety. Mining is a very important area where ignoring health has serious repercussions. Metallurgy is a very important area where ignoring health and safety standards have serious repercussions. It's high time that we start educating our workforce. They are capable, they are the first class workforce which we have. We are a very agile country, a young country. What we need is the kind of education, the kind of guidance, the kind of support to make them perform to the international standards. And this is not going to come through only by discussing things in seminar. We'll have to start practicing. I'm sure we all are gathered here to deliberate and discuss on them, and in the day-long deliberations we'll address those issues. First, I must thank the organizers for the great work they are doing, and I wish them and this program all success. Thank you very much.
Security, health and environment is very much important for any industrial place where we are having industrial activity. It is like a family where we look after a child. When a child moves around in the, when he learns moving around and move around, mother looks after the security. He should not fall down somewhere and he should not get hurt. Similar facility or similar concern industrial the industrial leaders or people who are running the industries and the government want to have for the our industrial worker. If our industrial worker is safe and they know how to handle the hazardous situation, their health will be maintained, environment will be taken care of, and we'll be able to run the more productivity. The purpose of this seminar is to talk about how we should have a health of the person to be there. If you are handling hazardous material, how you should be careful about it. I am very happy to know that Green Triangle Society has trained a large number of drivers for dealing with hazardous material. If they move with the material, they should know how to handle the situation if anything goes wrong. I am sure that we'll have a whole day deliberation, and able to talk about the various issues. Mr. Mathur and other faculty members will be able to train the trainers who can go back to their workplace and look after the security and safety aspect of the employees. Bacteria and Wireless Department has doing a tremendous job, and I am thankful for Green Triangle Society to help them in achieving the target, which is same. My best wishes, and I wish we'll enjoy the today's deliberation and learn from this, and able to send the mantra of safety, health and environment to all the people who are working for us, for welfare of the country, welfare of the state and welfare of the industries. All the best.
I was present, I think, for the first award ceremony when the awards, safety awards were given, and I had said that the work which is undertaken by them, in fact, helps to support the government, because it is sometimes government cannot reach each and every sphere, where such organizations can try to work in association with the government. We believe that safety is utmost importance. We have seen recently there was some leakage of naphtha in Zuwarinagar. In that, the fallout of that small leakage, I could actually see when I went there. And that is why I think safety of a worker for any industrial establishment is extremely important. We sometimes see that industries neglect that angle. But with societies like Green Triangle Society, working hand in hand with the government and with the industries, I think if some guidance is required, some more safety measures are required to be taken, I think this can be helped and guidance can be given by organizing such conferences. I must congratulate Bangiri Sriker and his team for having taken this initiative for organizing these conferences, plus for instituting the awards. I think first time safety awards were given in the state of Goa, and which received good response. Actually, people who do good work in the field of safety, I think they should be rewarded. And that is why I am sure today we have lots of keynote speakers, prominent people, who will be guiding you and telling you what steps are required to be taken in the interest of the workers, in the interest of the industry. And that is why I once again wish this conference all the success, and I am assuring you that whatever deliberations, whatever report you come out, whatever suggestions you come out, government will always support whatever suggestions or recommendations you come out with and give full support for organizing such type of events in the future.